Storer Stadium. And because there's still Indonesian players on courts, but our final match of the day features the six-time former champion, Lee Chong Wei of Malaysia, up against Anders Antonsen from Denmark. Well, this section of the draw, the bottom half, and you can see that Kenta Momota is through to play against Tommy Sugiarto. And the match with Viti Hus against Wang Chalong is on court right now, and I can tell you that Wang Chalong took the opening game 21-18 and is leading 17-11 in the second. So Lee Chong Wei making his 15th appearance at the Indonesian Open. Three consecutive titles, six titles in total here at this event, which is a remarkable record, but not as remarkable as him winning his 12th Malaysian Open title last week when contesting his 14th Malaysian Open final. Well, in the men's singles draw, we had three seed casualties in the first round. Chen Long, the Olympic champion and two-time former world champion, the defending champion, Srikanth Kadambi, and Song Wenho, the former world number one. Add to that that we lost Jano Jorgensen, the 2014 winner, and Lin Dan, the two-time Olympic champion. There was a few big names that disappeared from the first round. So Anders Antonsen, the first to appear on courts, and now Lee Chong Wei. Well, two titles already this year for Lee Chong Wei. It was not only the Malaysian Open last week, at the Commonwealth Games on the Gold Coast in Australia, became the first player to win three golds in the same individual event. This is the first meeting between the two players. I was a little bit surprised about that when I was researching this morning. But for Anders Antonsen, it will be a moment and a challenge that he cherishes. Well, you can see from his shirt that his warm-up has been heavily perspiring already. Vigorous warm-up that these players undertake. Well, just to bring you right up to date, I can tell you that Wang Chalong has beaten Viting Hus and awaits the winner of this match. Anders Antonsen, 21 years of age, born in Aarhus, and former European junior champion, won the title in 2015. And then at the senior European championships last year, got the silver medal. Well, as far as he's concerned, in the first round, he beat Kenta Nishimoto of Japan. Saved two game points in that second game before winning it 25-23. The best he's achieved so far this year is one quarter final, and that was the European Championships. Lee Chong Wei, 35 years of age now, born in Penang. Up two places on the world ranking this week, published earlier today, up to number four, but of course he is a former world number one. So as far as Lee Chong Wei, if you were with us yesterday, you would have enjoyed his match against Ng Kar Long of Hong Kong. He was 18-17 up in that second game, before losing four straight points in that second game, but was very dominant in the deciding game, as you can see. Exactly an hour before his first round match, So Richard Bramley from New Zealand is our umpire for this one. And Mai Lang Yen, the service judge, looks as if it's pretty difficult to look through that little device and really establish where 1.15 meters is, because that's the experimental rule that's likely to stay. Used to be that the players had to serve below the waist, and the waist was defined as below the lowest rib. But it was so difficult for service judges to determine where the lowest rib was that serves started creeping higher and higher and higher, and it was felt that the best option was to have a fixed height and say that all players must serve below 115 centimetres. Controversial decision, with some of the tall players Chong Wei getting this second round match underway. Wasn't the best of low serves to start him off. Good opening rally. Longer opening rally to this men's singles than I think we saw throughout the whole of that mixed doubles. I was talking yesterday about Lee Chong Wei and his remarkable longevity and his support of the World Tour as it is now, but previously Super Series. Won 46 Super Series titles from 66 finals. Clearly the most prolific winner of Super Series titles that there was, and that's across all disciplines. Well, the other thing I talked about yesterday was how difficult it is to recover as you get older. Recovery time seems to take longer. When you're young, you can have a hard tournament and a hard match, and you bounce back the next day. I assure you, as you get a lot older, it takes a lot longer. Yep. Mishit from Antonsen. Set up the opportunity.
It's over. 2-3.
Overdone it, it's just wide.
Four.
perfect. Threaded it down the line. Come back in. Initial trajectory looked as if it was going to go well wide. Well, the left to right drift, and it came back into court. The problem is, when you see your opponents leaving the courts, there's a natural assumption that you can do the same. Yeah. I don't think I'd play Lee Chong Wei at the flat fast exchanges. Because that's liable to happen all the time. Very good from Lee Chong Wei, steadily moving his opponents. In the end, outmaneuvering him, waiting for the right opportunity to go for the winner. Oh, he took it. Yeah. Well, there was real hesitation from Antonsen.
Seven.
Yeah. Let it drop, then thought I need to hit it. It was a good deceptive return of serve. And he has to do that. He has to try and get Lee Chong Wei off balance. That's a lovely shot. All about disguise and angle. And that's what I was alluding to. Get him off balance, Lee Chong Wei.
Six.
by playing deceptive shots, because Lee Chong Wei, in my opinion, is one of the best retrievers in the sport. Well, he doesn't have a lot of weaknesses, the Malaysian, as he proved last week. Oh, I don't believe it. Well, he thought for a moment it was going to go over. Lee Chong Wei did awfully well with that one. That was terrific. Well, I didn't miss by much, but it was definitely wide. Balance to start with. And then produces a shot like that. Terrific. From the Danish youngster. Well, when I talk about consistency, Lee Chong Wei reached 36 consecutive Super Series tournament semi-finals. And that's some Super Series tournaments played. Richard Bramley, that Lee Chong Wei needs to get ready quicker, and Antonsen, when he sees that his opponent is not ready, needs to wait until he is ready. They both need to play their part. From White. I think it's good that the umpires have obviously been instructed by the tournament referee, Greta Frimsluh, that they've got to be a little tougher on the amount of time wasting that goes on. And I think it's an overdue directive that should be used the whole time. Good return. So it is the six-time former champion who has the advantage at the mid-game interval, albeit just one solitary point advantage. Hendrawan, former Indonesian player, Wilson Way's coach. Former world number two himself in the men's singles. Coach in Denmark, the head coach. Well judged. Well, it seemed from Hendrawan's gestures that he was urging his man to play with a little more urgency. First two rallies since the resumption of play would indicate that my theory is probably correct. Well taken from Antonsson. Good net exchange. Very well taken. Judgment. He hasn't got the hang of this sideways drift yet, Lee Chong Wei. Smash down the forehand side, then down the Antonsson backhand side, making the Dane twist and turn. Well, the problem is that you know that 16, unless you play a very good return of serve, 12. Lee Chong Wei is going to have command of the rally. Therefore, Antonsson going for a little too much on the return. From Lee Chong Wei. From wide. Yeah, it was just a half smash. It's so clever because he's hit harder smashes earlier on. Just mixing up the pace, it means that Antonsson can't settle in his defensive play. If everything comes at you at the same angle and the same pace, you get into a bit of a rhythm defensively. And it's always mixed up, and then you're unable to do that. Once again, Lee Chong Wei really working Antonsen, playing him to all four corners. Away from the opening game.
19-12.
8 of the last 10 points. Oh, I thought that was going out. It certainly has. So game point opportunities for Lee Chong Wei. Yeah, well, I'm not surprised the umpire is surprised by the challenge, because it was well long of the back line. In badminton terms, it wasn't even close. Lee Chong Wei standing ready to serve on game point, because that's confirmed by Hawkeye that
challenge unsuccessful. One challenge remaining. 20.
Yeah.
Game point.
Kenny Ronison knows that was a tactical challenge.
Game.
He really has fallen away since the mid-game interval.
First game won by Lee Chong Wei, 21-12.
21-12, so 10 of the last 12 points. And when it was 11-10 at the mid-game interval, I thought that Hendrawan was urging Lee Chong Wei to play a little more aggressively, with a little more urgency, and he did precisely that. Raced away with the opening game. 21-12 in 21 minutes. Oh, he looks a little more relaxed now, Hendrawan, in his coaching style. Chong Wei looking very relaxed now.
Court one, 20 seconds. Court one, 20 seconds. Second game, level, play.
So one game to the good, the six-time former champion.
Over. One, love.
Oh, well taken. You could just see he was ready to pounce, Lee Chong Wei.
It's over. One. All.
Yeah, I think that's the first use of the body smash from Antonsson all match.
It's over. Two. One. Settle.
Oh dear, never got behind that.
It's over. Two. All. Handle. Play.
Play. It's taking that too late as well.
Three.
Looks to me as if Antonsson isn't quite sure how he's actually going to win the points.
Four,
he's staying in the rally, but
two.
It doesn't seem to be with enough purpose. And suddenly tries a winner, which isn't really on. Oh, that was very good. That was well taken by the Danish youngster.
It's over. Three. Four.
Reach. Brilliant, absolutely magnificent from Lee Chong Wei. Oh, that rally, a prime example of him at one stage being in all sorts of trouble and turning the whole momentum of the rally by not just getting it back, but getting it back with interest.
Too much going to the back of the court. Please stay towards the middle of the court and off the red carpet as well. Play must be continuing. Play. No. Play.
Well, Lee Chong Wei wants the court mopped.
I can't have you going to the back of the court all the time. I am. I can give you breaks. That's how.
Well, Antonsson arguing that it'd been a really long rally. Well,
five,
yes, it had,
three.
But the umpire is right. Play must be continuous.
Four. over. 4-5.
Well, rare error on the return of serve from Lee Chong-wei. And I think both of the players are a little bit riled, actually, by the umpire's strictness.
5-5.
But I have to say, I don't disagree with the umpire. Myself and my colleagues have felt for some time that there's been an awful lot of time wasting going on by players in between rallies. Rally. Well, Lee Chong-wei can't believe
seven.
That wasn't called a fault.
5.
Well. With the fixed height measurement of the serves, the other thing that's changed with the serve is that the racket no longer has to be pointing in a downward direction. So players can hit a flatter serve. Yeah, finds the line. And this is 4 straight points. No, it's not, it's 5 straight points for Antonsson.
8-5.
Short. Yeah. But the run comes to an end.
Driver. 6-8.
Yeah, that's another good use of the body smash. Towards the right hip of Lee Chong-wei.
Anders.
Well, he's going to have another word with Antonsson, the umpire.
Play on the court, not the red carpet.
Well, not to leave the court and go onto the red carpet.
9-6.
Oh, that was going out, surely. String's gone in the racket of Antonsson. Yeah, that's why he made the error. It was a bit of a desperation shot from deep in the forehand corner, playing the drive cross court. Just wants to try out the new racket.
over.
Wide, taken with the drift. Yeah, it was a nice idea.
Eight,
we do have
nine.
To be very, very careful with any short hit now on the right hand side of the court as we're looking down right now. The back level.
Nine. All.
That actually looked a tired shot to me from Antonsen, that backhand.
Over. Ten. Nine.
Smash. Oh, that is fantastic. Yeah, he was encroaching in on the net, Antonsen. Didn't believe that Lee Chong Wei could play that to the back of the court.
It's over. Ten. All.
There's the body smash again, but Lee Chong Wei's alert to it now. That goes well long, and it is Lee Chong Wei who has the 1 point advantage at the mid-game interval. Which is the only advantage he had in the opening game, but it was straight after the mid-game interval that Lee Chong Wei promptly won 10 of the next 12 points. That was going to go long.
Court one, 20 seconds. Court one, 20 seconds.
Calmly walking towards his kit box before the shuttle had even landed. Oh, yes, that's very nice. He's got to make the effort to get to the shuttle early, Antonsen.
Over. 11. All.
He'll take the shuttle late against Lee Chong Wei. Lee Chong Wei just completely and utterly controls the rallies. Yeah. Well, that's the sort of injection of pace of movement and pace of shot that we saw from Lee Chong Wei in the first game after the big game interval.
It's over. 12-11.
Yeah, now that's what I was alluding to earlier when I said that Antonsen sometimes
11.
Doesn't really know how he's going to win a rally, and then he tries a little bit of trickery like that. That, quite frankly, there's a 1 in 10 chance of it working. Missed it.
It's over. 12-14.
That's a great lift. Then plays back to the net, making Antonsen move from front to back to front again. By the heavy breathing,
14.
Seems to be taking its toll on the Dane. Oh, what a return from Antonsen. And then what a lift. Good rally. Unbelievable defense. I don't believe it. I do not believe it. Yeah. Well, Lee Chong Wei made Antonsen, I think, play an extra 10 shots. How on earth did he stay in that rally in the early stages? 33 shots. I think that's the first time we've had a rally length in this men's singles match. I'd be surprised if that's the longest one so far, but it might be. Clever. No, it's landed in. And Antonsen into the lead. A delightful reverse slice straight drop from Lee Chong Wei. Look at that. Creating the disguise by putting on the reverse slice.
Thank you. It's over. 15-all.
Well, it's amazing. Both men breathing very heavily, looking quite tired. I can understand why Lee Chong Wei would be tired. An accumulation of matches
16.
From last week, five matches. This is second match this week. But when the umpire actually enforces the continuous play rule, then fitness is really tested. And so it should be. Oh, he slipped. Lee Chong Wei. Oh, that's just amazing. Back to the same place where he slipped before. And he plays the perfect, perfect net shot. Most players would be nervous going back to that same place where you've just slipped. Four straight points.
18.
This is where 15. Lee Chong Wei is so good. This is where champions separate themselves from contenders. Crucial moments, they up their game, win the big points. Oh, that's just ridiculous. Absolutely ridiculous. How can he do that, Lee Chong Wei?
19.
Gets back the 15. Net cord with a perfect, absolutely perfect net cord himself. That is class. Good lift. That was landing right on the back line. And Lee Chong Wei has earned himself match point opportunities.
20.
On a run of six straight points from 14-15 down.
15.
Seven straight points from 14-15 to close it out, 21-15. Lee Chong Wei demonstrating why he is such a great champion. Looked to be under pressure when trailing in that second game. But then just ups the ante.
21-12. 21-15.
21-12, 21-15 confirms the umpire. 47 minutes of play. And into the quarterfinal, where he will meet Wang Chalon of Thailand. So their confirmation, 47 minutes in total. So 21-12, 21-15. So that concludes our second round action for today. as the players take leave of the court. There is one match remaining, as you can see, women's doubles on court number two. But our matches have concluded, which all started with the defending champions in the mixed doubles, the world and Olympic champions, Tantowi Ahmad and Liliana Nasir, coming through in two close games against the Japanese pair of Kobayashi and Matsutomo. Then Kento Momoto, the 2015 winner, came from 7-13 down in that second game, promptly winning 14 of the next 16 points to close it out in two straight games. Then Berian Griawan and Hardianto, winners of the Australian Open earlier this year, beat the European champions in double quick time. Only 32 minutes for their victory there. Then Rachano Quintanon, who was a winner here in 2015, former world champion, beat the reigning world junior champion in three games. The crowd very much enjoying that one. Then it was the world number ones in the men's doubles, Gideon and Sogumolio, who have won three titles so far this year. Well, they were 8-10 down in that second game, 13 of the next 15 points to win in just 27 minutes. Then it was women's singles, and the three-time former champion Sina Nehwal didn't have the answers today against Chen Yufei. Of course, both those players bronze medalists at last year's World Championships. Then it was women's doubles and the former world number ones, Fukushima and Hirota, winning a very close two-game match against a brand new pair from Malaysia, one actually on their third match point opportunity. Then in the men's doubles, the beaten finalists from last week were beaten this week by Liu Mingcheng and Su Ching Heng, one also on their third match point, as had happened in the women's doubles, the men's doubles pair from Chinese Taipei. Then it was a very one-sided mixed doubles with two-time former mixed doubles champion Jiang Nan with his new partner Li Hun Wei, too good for last year's World Championship bronze medalists Li Chun Hei and Chao Hoi Hua. Just 27 minutes, 21-6 in that second game. And then Li Chong Wei, coming from 14-15 down in that second game with seven straight points to close out against Antonsen, 21-12, 21-15. So quarterfinals tomorrow, another 10 matches for you, same time as today. That's 12 noon local time, that's 0500 GMT. From all of us here in Jakarta, we'll see you tomorrow. Bye for now.